also playing once again with DigitalBlock. Tonight, Digital welcomes producer of TheSamRBLX with ROBLOX, not ROBUX. Not featuring Sky and the Premium Comedy Band again. And now, live on tape from a spooky unknown location, here's DigitalBlox. Oh, spooky.
Hey, buddy, welcome to Up Late. I am your host, DigitalBloxed, and my oh my, the studio looks good. As you can probably see, we have decorated our studio for the spookiest day of fall, Halloween! Now let's not waste time talking about useless shit, because we have absolutely no time to spare. So let's get right to the monologue. But actually, before we do that, let's say hello to Kirk. Hi.
Hi.
Just before we go into the monologue, I just want to go back to when President Trump contracted the coronavirus. And I thought to myself, how would he believe he could beat it?
Hey, look at this! Donald Trump! Oh my god! The hostile takeover of Donald Trump on Vince McMahon!
Oh, right. Thank you for your input. That was... very good. Thank you.
I know. Thank you.
Now that we're on the topic of talking about Trump, Trump held a lot of rallies over the past weeks and showed off some of his iconic dance moves.
Pick yourself off the ground, I said, young man, 'cause you're in a new town, there's no need.
Awkward. You know what he reminds me of? Grandpa Simpson. I mean, he dances just like him.
No, hold on. Did you say Grandpa Simpson? It's Abe Simpson.
Abe Simpson, a.k.a. Grandpa Simpson.
No, it is okay. Not called Grandpa Simpson.
It is Grandpa Simpson. Or 225,000 Americans dead because of COVID-19 and his stupid ass not caring at all. And he's dancing? That's why we need to vote him out. Do we want a president who thinks 225,000 people dead is acceptable? How stupid do you have to be?
Calm down, chill out. Whoa.
I'm sorry. I'm calm. Then he went on to say this.
And we will make America safe again. And we will make America great again.
Now, let me tell you a secret. That won't happen! Now, when he started shouting like an old man with a hearing problem, I could see the resemblance of when Kimberly Guilfoyle started screeching at the Republican National Convention.
Ladies and gentlemen, leaders and fighters for freedom and liberty and the American dream, the best is yet to come!
Well, that's enough Trump news for tonight. It hurts my brain to even talk about him. TV show King just had its finale last Friday, and it was a tense game. The four finalists that made it were tough rivals, and it came down to the wire when people swapped places left and right, along with Kirk realizing it was a horrible idea to finalize this stuff an hour before the show starts.
He's not wrong.
I am not. The show ended with Uncharted Dimensions winning 100 Robux, and the game crashing, which also led to the show off of a new TOF menu that's basically a DMCA takedown from Nintendo, as it's just the Wii menu.
I don't know what you got a problem with. It's beautiful. It's beautiful.
It doesn't work.
It does work.
It has the Eric Andre show.
Your point?
We want the news channel and weather channel on this.
Can you? Yes. Give it a month. We need to work on it.
Okay. Well, we got a great show for you tonight. My guest tonight is a producer of many game shows, TheSamRBLX. But when we come back, the newly invented, never before seen segment, Headlines. Stick around.
Wow.
We'll be right back.
It does taste better.
Chicago's original submarine, Mr. Submarine.
This is 1 6-footer. I can't handle one-on-one. Ladies, let's have a party.
Choose from Mr. Submarine's great lineup of your favorite subs. Mr. Submarine's king-size sub, a regular sub piled high with your favorite meats and cheeses.
For the best-tasting meal around, Mr. Submarine is the real stuff.
Chicago's original submarine, Mr. Submarine.
Hey, welcome back to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Now, as you probably know, we used to do skits and segments sometimes after the monologue, but then never stuck with them and completely abandoned them. Well, not this time, because we have been hard at work making the perfect segment for you all. We compiled the finest headlines from all over the world.
We did?
No. And put them into a segment called... Alright, let's get to it. A burglar who left behind a rucksack containing his name and address at the scene of crime has been jailed for 4 years. So, a man named Malcolm Pike broke into a garage in Sutherland and accidentally left behind a bag which contained both his name and address. Now, I don't know about you, but this is clearly not a good way to make friends. A man has been jailed for 6 weeks after breaking the Isle of Man's coronavirus quarantine rules by going to McDonald's with his friends. I want McDonald's. Now, that's the second time a person has been sent to jail because of McDonald's. The first one being the Hamburglar in 1971. Netflix. Yeah, Netflix is said to be planning a free 48-hour streaming event in a bid to get more people signing up for the platform. The event is reportedly going to be called How Sad Enough Are You to Sit Through Every Single Adam Sandler Movie? Now, might I suggest starting with That's My Boy?
Who made up these jokes?
Michael.
Oh, that explains a lot.
Big money now.
We'll save you more. Call 410 284-3244. Presto Electric.
You don't have time to lose.
Nobody here has time to lose.
Waiting around is such a snooze.
I'm rapping to the beat. Just bang, bang your keyboard to the boogiest of beats. With Print and Go, you gotta know, you can renew tabs anytime. It's Express SOS.
Waiting around is such a snooze. No time to lose.
Up online, not in line, with ExpressSOS.com. Ouch!
And that's a wrap.
It's painless.
Hi, I'm Steve Miller. I've been a trial lawyer in Florida and Massachusetts since 1985. If you and your spouse hate each other like poison and want to get out of the hellhole you call a marriage, you've come to the right place. Look, you can waste your money screwing around with some paper pusher paralegal type, give thousands of dollars to some piece of crap three-piece suit downtown, blow your brains out trying to figure out why you wasted 25 bucks on the crappy forms you bought from the illiterate boob at the courthouse, or do what I say and do it now. We know what we're doing here. Look at this website, a work of art. Here's the story. Pay us a little and we get you a lot. Don't worry about the details. We'll take care of business and let you know when to crack open the champagne. Okay, time to move on. Go to the Get the Divorce page in the upper right corner, pay up, and you're on your way to getting rid of that vermin you call a spouse. We're here to help. Divorce EZ, a Florida law firm.
Hey, welcome back to Uplate. My guest tonight is probably one of the best producers in TOF and GCW.
Oh,
he also stars. He also stars alongside Kirk in The Eric Andre Show and is absolutely mentally insane. Please welcome Sam.
Well, Digital just insulted a handicapped person in a sense. He's being fired.
Oh yes. So first off, how are you?
I'm doing pretty incredible. I don't know how. I cannot believe we have cactuses. Why is this a food or a drink? I don't know.
It is a drink.
What?
Believe it or not, you can drink it.
Hold on. Okay, let me give it a try.
Okay.
Oh! We're not Derek. We're not.
It hurt.
That is exactly what it's supposed to be. So first off, what are you wearing?
It's a shirt Hannibal Buress wears. Come on, look at that.
I think he means the Pepsi part.
I'm not talking about the shirt. I'm talking about the T-shirt.
It's Hannibal Buress, Pepsi.
It looks like Pitbull to me.
Don't question, Sam. Just don't.
So how's Wheel of Fortune going?
It's going good. We're in our fourth season, and we are in the 1980s set. And
yeah,
I just love how the fact that in the actual series they always say, "Put it on a gift certificate." Well, in the series, it's actually opposite, because everyone is like, let's put it on account. We don't care. Let's just we just want to risk our money. For future shopping, yeah.
Sure. So what made you think to use the 70s era?
You said it was 80s. How do you get this wrong?
70s. Yeah, 1980. Yeah.
Whatever.
That was actually not my plan. It was actually Wheel's plan because that was by decision, because we wanted to do this because to bring the C how the shopping ever would go for our contestants. Yeah. And by the way, we still have the bonus round for that anyway. Because usually in IT, they don't have a bonus round. But in the version of this one, we're like, screw it, we don't have to follow strict guidelines. Let's just add to the current bonus round game. Yeah. And it's still a blast.
It is. Yeah. Now you co-host the Eric Andre Show with the genius without a brain, Kirk.
Hey, hold on. No. Shut your mouth. This is why you're not getting removed.
Never mind that it's on break. Right.
I can't
now,
wait.
But...
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. That show will probably be back in 2047.
He's got a point.
Probably.
He's got a point.
Yeah.
Yeah, I do got a point. Because... we haven't even taped a show since, what, 5 months?
May, 5 months. Yeah. So, how is it actually to co-host an insanely funny talk show? And how is it behind the scenes?
Well, we usually have to get the things in order. Usually, I love how it's more chaotically unoriginal.
Sam complains that we don't have a script like every episode.
No,
it doesn't need
a script.
I
mean, I don't care if we have a script. Come on.
You still complain about something. Okay. Like when Johnny steals your seat, like every episode. On your feet, Luigi. Well, you heard it here. Season 5, Hannibal Buress leaves the Eric Andre Show. That way, that means Sam's leaving the show. I'm sorry, Sam.
Oh.
I'm sorry, Sam. Oh. That the season 5 says otherwise.
Well, I'm gonna leave this show too. Bye.
No. Great interview.
I'm just kidding.
Aw.
Okay. So you're a wrestler for a thing called GCW, where you play Samberg. Is that correct?
Yeah.
So
it's actually Samberg.
Yeah. So how is it actually working on GCW?
GCW champion ever. What was that again?
I said, what is it like working on GCWCW?
It's insane. It's insane. The chaotic, the chaos. It's incredible. I've never seen So much. We have Halloween Havoc coming, and we're going to have a match that no one even expects. So if you're going to come to that show, no one expects. So,
Sam versus Sam.
I'd like to see that.
Who versus who? Who versus me?
Sam versus Sam.
The winner like wins the Sam Championship.
The thing is, I have never won a match. And you want to know the only match I won again? It was against the man, the myth, the legend, Batman. Batman, yeah. Batman.
Okay. Congratulations, you won against Batman. Now, as I said before, you're a sports fan. So my question is, why?
Why are you insulting him for being a sports fan, hon?
Because it's so crazy. Because it's so electric. The atmospheres are electric. Well, not in the pandemic, but the temperatures are still electric. And I still cannot believe Tampa, the Lightning, decided to... And don't forget, Cleveland. We want to look at those teams who blew a 3-1 leads. The Cleveland Indians, Golden State Warriors, the Atlanta Braves. There are a ton of them who blow a 3-1 lead. It's amazing.
It is. It is. Now, real quick about your shows. As I said, you're probably one of the best producers in TOF and GCW. And you produce shows like Wheel of Fortune, Press Your Luck, and many, many more. So how do you manage all of the shows at once?
Because, I'm usually busy. Yeah, me. I'm usually busy for what? I'm usually a busy man, and, I have never missed a show often. Yeah.
Unless it's TV show, King.
Or any TRN show.
Oof.
TV show game. I only missed season episode 14 because I kept on struggling to get on there. Yeah.
And do you have any other shows you want to bring to the community?
I don't know. Not sure.
Not sure.
Aw.
You I'm should. Sure. You should.
I'm not sure. Yeah. Because school is getting me. Like, seriously.
Yeah. Well, it is getting everyone. Well, I know you've brought a mini game to the show for us to play, so yeah, stick around and we'll be right back with more of Uplate.
Hi folks, I'm Frankie Flight. I want you to check out Hoop Wireless next to Subway, Quitman Highway, right here in Moat. To tell your family, friends, and neighbors to come in and check us out. Check out all our plans. That and much more. Hoop Wireless. Hoop
Hi,
Wireless.
Hi, Lady Jock. Come in and check out Julio. He'll hook you up right here. Hoop Wireless.
Hoop Wireless. Hoop Wireless.
Hey, how y'all doing? This is Julio with Hoop Wireless. Come and check us out. We got anything you need as far as wireless goes.
Hoop Wireless. Don't forget to check out Hoop Wireless. Next to Subway, Equipment Highway, right here in Moultrie.
Hoop Wireless.
This is the third time editing this. It's an iMitzi random.
Christmas cards.
God, I love writing Christmas cards. Especially in October. Nearer the Halloween. Who should I write a Christmas card to? I could write one to Wise. Or maybe to JC. Nah. Apparently they blocked my email. Yeah, boy, well, who should I write a card to? I know, Hertz. Hertz is nice. He does pyramids. Well, time about the card. Nice music. To Hertz. Thank you for an amazing year. Also, you still owe me money. Love from Michael Page. How nice. Now I need to add a gift to it. Hang on. Oh, dehydrated.
Oh, look. A letter. What the...
This took too long to edit.
Yahoo! It's computer time in the city. Woo! It's time for ComTech, your one-stop computer shop. Woo!
Are you on the net yet? You gotta call ComTech.
Monthly internet service, only $17.95. Internet-ready complete computer system at ComTech, only $5.99.
Are you on the net yet? You gotta call ComTech.
Call ComTech.
Welcome back to Up Late. Sam bought a game, like I said, and yeah.
This is a game. This is buzzers. This is the game where when you spam the buzzers and then everything goes fucking crazy. It's crazy.
Exactly.
Yeah, and then usually at the end their heads explode. Yeah, this was probably from season 2. So yeah.
Well, this is not the Eric Andre show. So, we've stole something from the Eric Andre show.
I'm gonna kill myself. Just play the game.
It's time to play Buzzers. Get ready. Get set. Go!
We'll be right back after this short commercial break.
An afternoon at the salon before the big night out. $200. The big night out. $5,000. Coming home the next morning after the big night out. $25,000 and counting. An afternoon in the park after Michael Gallagher's gotten you visitation with your kids? Priceless. I'm Mike Gallagher. Give me a call if you need help.
Well, that's it for Up Late. Big thank you to Sam for being here tonight and having fun.
Now I get to steal Kirk's seat.
What? Okay. We will be back after the presidential election, and we are either going to be in a good mood or in a not so good mood.
That depends if UC News doesn't steal the spotlight first. I think actually, speaking of the devil, I think I'm doing that tonight. Fuck. Well, you know what they say, gotta get ready for the presidential election. I'm not blaming, I don't blame the news broadcast, I blame the election in general.
Yeah. Have a great time celebrating Halloween. Remember to stay safe out there and have a great night. Wait, who are you?
I am the man, the myth, the legend. I'm Eduardo.
Bye.
I take over the show. Good night.
Hey, did you like our episode? We did. I don't think Digital did. If you liked our episode and want to give us feedback, go to the description down below to find the feedback form. Don't forget, we'll have our next episode soon. Probably not.